I mute you all if you need me. Just unmute yourselves and yell at me. All right. I can unmute you. Does anybody have any special requests today? I'd like to work my cheeks. Okay. All right. I'm sorry. I'm in a weird mood. All right. Here we go. Right. So I just finished lifting weights 10 minutes ago, and literally my legs are still shaking. So I apologize if I fall over. Don't do what I'm doing. All right, guys, let's just start rolling our shoulders. Turn your trackers on. I got mine going. All right, here we go. All right, so we're gonna do quite a bit of arms and core stabilization today. So let's start by warming up the upper body a little bit. So go ahead and bring thumbs up, hands forward, then turn your palms out, or up rather, thumbs out, and reach back. Good, really squeeze your glutes here and squeeze your shoulder blades. Good, now inhale and clasp your hands above your head. And now tuck everything in, make a big letter C with your spine. Think about trying to push your belly button to the back of your mat. Good, and we're just gonna repeat that. Come open, here we squeeze. Pull the core in and squeeze your glutes, your shoulder blades. Inhale up and then curl. That should feel pretty good. Good, and reset one more time. Open. And up we go, inhale here. Exhale, curl everything in. Good, bring the arms down by your side, roll your shoulders, clasp your hands behind you. And we're opening up the front of our shoulders here. Spread your collarbones apart. Good, inhale up with one arm and you'll lean away from that arm. Good, we're just gonna switch sides. Guys, always remember to go within your range of motion. Listen to your body. Take a breath. Good, soft fold. So everything just folds onto your legs. Good, see if you can get your rib cage onto your legs. Knees are bent. Good, put your hands on the mat. Walk back to downward dog. Good, feet are about hip distance apart here. Roll those shoulders back away from your ears. Push your heels down. Now it's okay if the heels don't touch, but you wanna push them down like they're going to. See if you can draw your elbows in to like they're gonna touch right in front of your forehead, but obviously they can't, right? Take a big breath, let it out as a sigh. Good, and come forward into a plank. Oh my goodness, come forward into a plank. Good, chaturanga, lower down, sweep the body up. And again, we're doing up dog here, or you can keep it bent in cobra. And bring your body up to tabletop. Hands right under the shoulders. Good. Pull against gravity here. So start this cat stretch. It doesn't start at your head. It actually needs to start at your tailbone, tucking under, and then everything lifting from there. and come down into cat. And back up. And down. Good. Now find that neutral spine. So we've talked before, neutral spine should be like, if you imagine that your pelvis is a bucket and you can pour water out the front and out the back, you want to find that middle where the water doesn't pour out the front or the back. Obviously your bucket's sideways. All right, take a breath, draw down into the floor with your palms and your knees, roll your shoulders, take a breath. Exhale, push left heel back and your right arm forward. If you need to modify this, you can always just touch the floor here. Good. Inhale as you reset. And then exhale and switch sides. Reach out. Inhale and reset. Switch and reach out. So the real work here is not in the arm and the leg that are reaching out. I mean, they're working and down. The real work is coming from pushing into the earth with that standing knee and that standing hand, drawing up through the core. Switch and controlling your movement. So you're not really rocking side to side and down and switch again. Good, one more on each side. Back. And last one. Good, take your knees out toward the sides of your mat. Ease your hips back and let that child's pose soften your spine. Good, and bring yourself back to tabletop. Tuck your feet, lift to downward dog. And then try to keep your hands on the floor as you walk yourself to the top of your mat. Once you're there, inhale into a standing extension. So we're straightening the spine here, reaching the rib cage beyond the hips, and try to touch the rib cage down onto your thighs. Exhale and fold. Relax the crown of your head. Your forehead is towards your shins. If your eyes are open, you're looking through to the back of your mat. Good. Bend your knees. Lift your gaze. If you need to support, you can always put your hands on your thighs here. Press up. And inhale. Good. Exhale into prayer. Good. All right, we are going to do, it's kind of like a warrior three, but it's a single leg deadlift. So it's going to challenge your balance a little bit. What you're going to do is push your weight into your left leg. I want to keep my right leg flexed. And all I'm doing, my hands are going to come down. It's like I'm going to reach for my toes, but I'm only going to go about where my shins are so that I'm horizontal. And then I'm coming back up. Okay. Now, if you don't want to go that far, you just go as far as it's comfortable for you. We're going to do four of those. Really press through that standing leg. Really going to be activating the hamstring here. We're all probably going at a different pace. Too fast, it is easy to lose your balance. Good. And then after your fourth one, step back to a high lunge. Take a breath. So lots of core stabilizing there in order to hinge over. So we're really not bending from the spine there. You should feel that more in the back of your standing leg. Exhale, we're gonna turn to the left. So towards your front leg, twist your lunge. Good, just go as far as comfortable for you. Good, now just enjoy this breath. We're gonna spiral everything open into warrior two. Don't be afraid to move your feet. Good. So get this sense with your right hip of pulling your right hip in. So this is my right hip. So I'm actually thinking about pulling my hip in. Yeah, there's this, yeah, because I want my shoulders over my hips. Sometimes you'll see this. This is more of an like a half extended warrior, and we want to be here. Mm-hmm. So if I were in your living room right now, I might come up behind you and grab your back hand, pull it behind you, like pull it over, and put my hand on your hip. Imagine that. So there's this pushing and pulling. Mm-hmm. Good. Straighten your leg. Now we push with the upper body and pull away toward the back of our mat with our lower body. So we're moving in opposite directions that we were just holding. And just enjoy that triangle. Back off if you need to, make it yours. Soften your left knee and put your forearm on your knee. Now put your hand on your right hip. Good. Push your hip down. So I want to push my hip so it's not going toward the ceiling anymore. Now I don't want to reach out here and look with my gaze. And notice my sternum is now facing my mat. I want to open up toward the ceiling. So I'm looking past my biceps. So this is extended angle pose. Big, strong legs. Pull in the core, draw the rib cage inward, pull open through that top shoulder blade, and unhinge. Come up. Now you're going to take your left leg. That's the one that's at the top of your mat. And I just want you to walk it toward the left side of your mat. Now we can turn the hips. Good. So Taekwondo friends, it's almost like a front stance, but our back leg is wrong. It's still angled. Yeah, so we're in a warrior one, right? So big opening of the hips. Up you go. Good. Now we're doing things a little backwards. We've done this before, right? We're gonna go backwards today. Take a breath. Come forward, reach out, drop those hips. Now watch, I'm gonna pull back, touch my hands like I'm swimming. Come all the way back up and unhinge. That's it, reach forward. So rib cage to the leg, touch back, touch together and up. Inhale forward. Rib cage to the leg, touch back, forward, woo, and up. One more time. And up, woo, hands to the floor. Step back to downward dog. But you should be feeling that left leg. Give yourself a little walk here. Good, go ahead and drop to your knees. Good, and just drop, just enjoy a tabletop here for a moment while I show you our next move. So we're gonna do, and some of you are familiar with dolphin pose. It is a dolphin pose, but it's a little bit of a variation. So it looks like downward dog, but a little more like relaxed downward dog. So I bend my knees, okay? And if I were in full dolphin pose, my legs would be straight and I just lay my elbows down. So this is dolphin pose. We're not going to touch our elbows, but we are going to bend them like we're going to touch them and come back up. All right. So go ahead and lift those knees. Get to downward dog. And then just soften your knees a little bit. Good. So I need you to think about drawing your elbows in towards each other. And then just start to drop the elbows down like you can touch. Now, if your elbows do touch, that's okay. And then lift back up. Spread out those fingers and lift back up. Come down. Lift back up. Come down. And lift back up. Now come forward into your plank. You can drop this to the knees if you need to, but draw that rib cage inward. Come down. Now the elbows come next to me, right by my ribs, and push back up. Down, right by the ribs. Give your body a hug and push back up. Draw that rib cage in. Core is in. Down, up. One more time, down and up. And this time, just let your body relax to the floor. Reach out with your hands. And lift everything up. Hi, Penny. Good. Now be mindful of your belly. Pull that belly inward. Good. If you need to have your hands on the floor, you can do that. Good. Set your hands by your heart. Roll your shoulders open. Exhale up into cobra or adjust this into up dog. Big breath, move back into child's pose. Good, now just a little side stretch. We're gonna take our left hand and set it off to the left side of your mat. And now just put your right hand on top and pull back into your right side. Good, come center. And now we'll take our right hand off the right side of the mat, put the left hand on top. And ease it back. So I'm pulling from my left pinky to my left hip. Good. From here, recenter and roll up onto your shins. We're going to step forward with your left leg. So this is the same leg that was forward before. Sink into the center, big hip flexor stretch here. Good, now we're gonna counter revolve. So you're gonna go towards your back leg, all right? So I wanna create a lever, okay? So that it's not my core that's turning me. I wanna completely relax this. I'm gonna put my left hand on the inside of my leg and then I can push. See, that's my engine. And I can just turn. Good, just go as far as it's comfortable for you. Now, sometimes when you turn, you feel like you can push the hips a little further. Good, now, come back center, inhale, put your hands on the floor. Now it's just like somebody's behind you and they pull your hips backward. Yeah, really stretch into the back here and into your hamstring. Good, come forward. We're gonna counter revolve again. Inhale as you unhinge, and then exhale and revolve. Inhale, hands to the floor. Exhale, pull back. Good. It doesn't matter if your toe is pointed or flexed. You can do both. You'll feel it move into that, the front of your shin there, anterior tibialis. But really, this is about pulling your hips toward that back heel. And slide it forward. Inhale up. And exhale, relax your breath, turn. Hands to the floor. Exhale, pull back. Good, you're gonna take that back foot, set the toes to the floor, lift your lunge. Inhale, step all the way in. Once you're there, take a nice breath in a standing extension, and then exhale and fold. Bend your knees, lift your gaze, support if you need to, press all the way up. Roll your shoulders. Good, now I just want you to take your feet about the width of your mat. Maybe a little more if you're not vertically challenged like me. I just want you to soften, and all you're gonna do is let your body swing. Now notice I'm moving my feet. Right, don't lock your hips and your knees in. Just kind of let momentum take you, so I'm not forcing my core to turn. Yeah, just a little spinal release here. Very nice. Y'all look like you're dancing. All right, and come back to the top of your mat. Good, and inhale. Exhale, bring the hands down in front of you, set your weight into your right leg. Straighten that left, and here we go. Over, take your time, push through that back heel. Try to reach the back of your mat every time and unhinge. Right, try to feel the lengthening of the back of your standing leg and up. We're gonna do one more. And then step all the way back. High lunge. Beautiful. Inhale here. Twist toward your top leg, your front leg. So to your right. Again, just go as far as it's comfortable for you. No strain here. We're just letting the body breathe. Let it turn where it's going to turn. Enjoy a big breath and open up into your warrior two. Don't be afraid to move your feet. Good. So we want to imagine here someone's pulling on your back arm. And you're pushing in your hip. Straighten. Now someone's pulling on this hand, pushing that hip to the ceiling, over to your triangle. Really breathe into that space at the top there between your rib and your hip. Bend your right knee and put your left hand on your left hip. Good. Just pushing down. Reach up and over. Look past your bicep at the ceiling. So I'm trying to turn my sternum toward the ceiling. So really draw in through the rib cage. So my breath is free, but I am supporting through my core. And unhinge. I'm going to take my right leg, walk it toward the right side of my mat. And I'm in my warrior one. So warrior one is a little wider than shoulder width or shoulder width versus warrior two, I'm in a line. I'm gonna take a breath. Good big stretch here, yeah? Inhale, reach forward. Let the hips come with you. Yeah, reach back and touch. Reach up and unhinge. Uh-huh, good. And we go forward, come back, bring it up, and unhinge. Keep your breath moving. So the temptation as you start feeling this and back is to hold your breath. Breathe forward and unhinge. One more. Hinge forward, reach back, forward, and up. Good job. Hands to the floor. Step back to downward dog. Good. And this side, we'll go right to it. Bend your knees. Draw those elbows in towards each other. Exhale. Try to touch the floor with your elbows and press back up. Inhale down. Press up. Inhale down. Press up. Inhale down. Press up. Come forward into your plank. Knees if you need to. Draw in through the core. I know you're thinking about your arms. Draw down. Give your body a hug and press up. But I want you to really feel how your stabilization is what does the work for you. Down and up. Down and up. And down and up. Inhale as you chaturanga this time all the way to the floor. Good. Roll your shoulders back. So this time, instead of the arms reaching out, reach behind you, palms up, roll your shoulders, lift your heart here, and then add the legs if you want to. Think about pulling your shoulder blades into your back pockets. And bring your hands by your heart. Relax your legs. Exhale, push the body up into cobra or up dog. And back we go, child's pose. Good. Come up to tabletop, and this time, instead of our angled child pose, we're going to thread the needle. It's a little deeper. Take your left arm forward. Take a breath first with your right hand and rotate up. And then exhale and reach all the way through. If going to your shoulders too far, just stay on your elbow. Keep the tension out of your neck. Yeah, tensing your neck is not going to help your tailbone release, right? Good, bring it back to tabletop. Lift your left arm up to the left, inhale. Exhale, reach through. And reset, come up to your shins. We're gonna step forward with the right leg. Good, inhale up, settle into the center here. And then you're gonna rotate to your left. So your right hand goes to the inside of your right leg. And I'm just relaxing open. Inhale, hands to the floor. Someone just grabbed your hips, pulling you backward. Good, come forward, drop into the hips, unhinge, take a breath. Exhale and turn. Hands to the floor, take a breath, and exhale back. Try to make sure you're pulling equally through both hips. It's really easy to push or pull back into the kneeling hip. So it should be your left one right now, but think about that right one too. You come forward, inhale as you rise, exhale and turn. Hands to the floor and pull back. Good, we're gonna slide forward here. Lift your lunge. Step in, and once you get there, find a breath in your standing extension. Exhale and fold. Good, bend your knees and unhinge. Good, we're gonna do that spinal release again. So take your feet a little wider and just let your body swing. Let your legs come with. So we don't wanna torque the knee. Just a gentle release here. Just natural movement. Good. Now, keep your feet where they are, right? We're gonna go into garland pose. So if your heels come up, the first thing to do is try to take your feet wider, okay? Biggest mistake most people make is their feet are too narrow. But if it's a flexibility issue and your heels are gonna come up no matter what, then your hands need to stay on the floor, okay? So everybody start with your hands on the floor. And then you'll see I'm adjusting my width here and dropping my tailbone into my hips. Good, now if my heels are up, I can leave my hands out here and just push forward into my arms and I'm gonna get the same stretch. This is also good if you have a knee issue, but if you're good today, try to bring those hands up into prayer and just let your body swing under itself. Very nice. This is a huge spine opener. So really breathe into that space between your belly button and your lower back. Good, if your hands aren't already on the floor, go ahead and put them there. And just lift your hips, walk yourself back to downward dog. All right, I promise. That means I'm not lying. We're going to do those dolphins one more time, but we are going to combine them with the press. So soften those knees, draw the elbows in. Here we go. Drop down to dolphin. Push back up. Now shift forward, straight legs or bent knees. Come all the way down, push up. Now sit back. Down with the elbows and lift. Shift forward. Elbows stay by your side and up. Shift back. Elbows down and up. Shift forward, down and up. Last one. Here we go. Elbows down, up, shift forward, down and up. Good job. Just sit back. I'm going to do my child's pose this time with my legs closer in. A little more of a back release there. And then I'm going to take my arms, because they deserve it, by my side. Good. Reset your hands. Tuck your feet. Lift to downward dog. Good. And we're going to bring the right leg across the midline of our body. Good for pigeon. So you want to flex this bottom leg. Make sure this bottom foot is flexed. Now, ideally, the top of your foot behind you is pressing into the floor, and all the way to your pinky toe is on the floor. I want to square my shoulders and my hips up. Now, if I drop my hip, I'm not square anymore, okay? So, but if you have a knee issue, this is a great modification, but I'm still pushing and reaching back. All right, make sure that bottom leg stays flexed. Just take a breath. Now, this is not rounding over your front leg. Really reach your rib cage as far down your leg as you can. Doesn't mean you have to go forward. You can stay up. Keep your weight feeling as though it's pushing backwards. Be mindful of your front leg that's under you. Make sure you have not rolled forward onto your shin. If you have, just try to walk that back leg back a little further. Press it down. Good. Now find your breath for me. So it's easy to feel where you're breathing on your leg, right? But I want you to feel your back body. Let the rib cage expand behind you as you breathe. Good, and slowly walk that up. Very nice job. Put your hands on the floor and bring yourself back to downward dog. And when you're ready, come to the other side. Just notice where you're different. You should be better on one side than another. Make sure you flex this front leg. I am modifying to the knee today. You don't have to. Just remember, we're trying to get these hips as square as we can to the front of our mat. Again, reach the rib cage. Man, you don't have to reach. If staying up high gives you a better sensation where you need it, then stay where you need to stay. Good. Walk that up. Now we're going to take your back leg, swing it around in front of you. Just take the legs out in front. Sit up nice and tall. Flex your feet, press your legs into the back of your mat, and find your prayer here. Good. Inhale up. Now press the bottom of your rib cage forward. Now just listen. Turn your rib cage. Reach for the outside of your left foot. If you can't reach your left foot, just grab the outside of your shin, right? So nice turn here. Your hand is behind you like a kickstand, but it doesn't have to be. If you want to swim that behind you on the small of your back, you can. Good. Now, before you unhinge, let go and then unhinge. Good. Sit up tall again. Let the hinge happen first, then turn the ribs, and I'm reaching for the outside of my leg, wherever that may be. Hand can stay behind you pushing, or it can wrap behind you. Good, and release that first, then unhinge. Come all the way down, and you're gonna make a big X with your body. Yep, so my legs are off my mat. Good. Good, now I need you to pay attention to your lower back. Pull your lower back down into the floor as much as you can. Now take a big breath. Now try to keep everything straight. Lift your right leg and your left arm. Crunch up off the floor and try to touch. Come back down. Good, do that side again. Take a breath. Same side, up. Just touch it and hold. And come back down. Good, we're trying not to go fast. Do that side again, because we really want to let the core stabilize. So there's just an isometric squeeze here. And then we drop down slowly. Oh, I don't know about you, but I want to just flop to the floor. Last one, up, hold it. And down. Take a breath. Just relax for a moment. And now draw that core back down. Get your core ready. Draw the rib cage in. Here we go. Right arm, left leg. So my right shoulder is lifting off the floor, but my left one is not. Head lifts off the floor. And all the way down. Control that descent. Gravity saying, oh, let me help you. Don't let it. And up. Breathe. Feel this squeeze here. Breathe. And then let it down. And exhale up. And then squeeze as you breathe. Don't hold your breath. Come back down. And one more time. Up. Hold. And let it down. Whew. Bring your feet to your mat. Knees are in the air. Good. Take your right leg across your left leg. So figure four here. Good. Now don't draw your knee in yet. I want you to leave it here, but then I want you to twist your spine. So you're actually going to twist to your left and try to put your right foot on the floor, but keep your figure four. Both shoulders stay on the floor. Now bring that back to the center, then inhale. Now I'm gonna exhale and draw my left knee with my foot on it toward my face. So use that left leg here as like an engine. You should be able to do this without your hands. You can draw your right leg in with your left. And then you can just add the arms for a little extra. Breathe into your lower back here. Good, let that release, feet to the floor, and set your left foot on your right quad. Take a breath. We're gonna drop to our right, putting your left foot on the floor. Bring that back to the center, inhale. Exhale, draw that in. Again, use your right leg. Pull your leg in. Try to relax that left hip as much as you can. And put that down. But put your feet together and your knees apart. Relax in this reclined bound pose for just a moment. Now we've been pulling our core down. I want you to let your back arch. Good. Reach over your head. Relax your breath here. Breathe all the way down into your hips and your belly. Good, let your arms come around. Feel that back, lower down to the floor. Bring your knees in and give them a hug. Put your feet on the floor. Good, now leave your feet on the floor and your knees up. Relax your back. Bring your hands behind your head. So just clasp your hands and put them behind your head. Good, so this last stretch that we're doing, I need you to take your head and press it into your fingers. So your arms actually do the work. You should feel this in your back. It is not a crunch, so try to keep your core out of it. So we're gonna lift our elbows toward the ceiling, but I'm still pushing into my hands, and I'm gonna pull my head up with my arms, so not my core. I'm just letting my head fall into my hands. You should feel this down the back of your neck and possibly into your rhomboids, that space between your shoulder blades. And just slowly, one vertebra at a time, traveling back up to your head. Lower your head down. And if you'd like to leave your knees up, just let them fall together now. And begin to move into a rest pose that's going to work for you today. Remember, it does not have to be where you always go. Begin focusing in on your breath. See how long you can make your inhale. And then see if you can make your exhale match that inhale. Feel your jaw relax. And just travel through your body at your own pace and stop anywhere that you know of some tension that you have. And see if you can imagine your breath going into that point of tension like a single point. And then as you breathe, imagine circles going out from that point like ripples on a pond. And let that tension release with your breath. And begin to feel your body in contact with the floor. Just tune into that breath again. Begin to feel yourself rocking side to side. And just pick a side, roll to one side. Spend a breath or two there. Let your back decompress. And when you're ready, you can press yourself up. Keep your back soft. Join me seated. Good. Go ahead and bring your hands into prayer. Take a breath up. Good. Now find your sit bones on the floor. You're going to reach over to one side. But what's important is that you leave this hip bone on the floor. Just gently reach. Good. And just make your way to the other side. Again, keep both sit bones on the floor. Good. And inhale up. Exhale to center. And God bless you guys. Namaste. Woo, woo. You made it through another week. Good job, you guys. I'll see you Monday. Let me know if you have any questions. Awesome job.
Thank you, Miss Kelly. Have a blessed weekend.
Thank you. I appreciate you guys.
We appreciate you.
Thank you, Kelly. Always awesome.
It was awesome.